Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
Right off the bat, Bob Dyce, the special teams coordinator. What went into your mindset for that one?
It's something once George came on board, you know, we pretty much decided how to shape the staff. And when we looked at it, I thought he was the best fit internally. And then we looked throughout the league. Bob has experience with doing it in Winnipeg. I think Bob is a good coach. The players respect him. And I think that, he's very knowledgeable, and I think he'll do a good job in that role.
Do you feel it's a bit of a gamble going on a guy with not extensive experience in that role?
No. I mean, I can use Mark Killam, for example. He was a young guy that once Craig left in, in Calgary, he came in and did a phenomenal job. And I think he's one of the top coordinators in the league, if not the top special teams coordinator right now. And, you know, we moved on and we did a good job with Killam. I think we'll do the same with Bob.
Tell us about Todd Howard.
Todd, I tell you what, no-nonsense type guy, very big, tall, all that good stuff. It's amazing. I talked to one of the guys. I was asking him when I was interviewing him. I kept asking him about, you know, give me a guy, you know, or something, blah, 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 blah. And it was always Todd Howard. Everybody I interviewed, they'd always say they lost a job to Todd Howard. They lost a job to Todd Howard. So I was like, well, I probably don't need to be talking to you guys. I probably need to find Todd Howard. So found Todd Howard, and, it's good for us to get a guy of that caliber in the CFL.
Is he close to being first or second to Mike Sinclair? Where would he get on? Did you have him on your radar before, Mike?
Yes, I've had him on there. I've actually had him on there since I've taken the job. It was one of those that, you know, I've heard his name for a while. Of course, he coached Justin Hickman, so I've been knowing his name, and that was a good reference to have. But, you know, Mike, like I said, Mike and I have a personal relationship. I didn't have one with Todd before, but he's always been said to be a good coach.
Can a defensive line coach improve the pass rush, or do you still need a good pass rush?
You know, the one thing about him is what I'll tell you about Todd is when we start talking personnel, I never hear him like, this is what we have to have. He's like, what we have is good enough and we'll improve. Everywhere he's been, he's improved. They've improved the numbers, whether it be the rushing, whether it be the sacks. And he's one of those that whatever you give him, he's going to turn it and make it better. But at the end of the day, the biggest thing that told me about Todd is in the interview process, he's like, I like sacks. I was like, okay, you got a job.
Was he kind of surprised that he got another chance at this job, considering you had hired someone else before?
You know what? I don't even think, you know what I'm saying? I hadn't talked to him at that point. But it was just one of those things where we have a lot of, you know, mutual friends and mutual guys that we've coached for and or played with, but more so coached for. And my name floated by him, and his name floated by me. So I thought it was a good opportunity for him to work for us, and I think it'll be a positive.
So you have Doug on the other side. He doesn't want to give up sacks, then?
That's the same thing Doug said. He said he didn't want to give up sacks. He said he wanted to be good in what we do, and he says we got to cut down the sacks. So his whole contract, he doesn't get paid. It's off of sacks. So every game, if there's no sacks, he gets money. Other than that, he's not getting paid.
So he got paid a lot this week.
Yeah.
How much is his familiarity? I mean, he was in
Hamilton last year, right? He was there last year with George, Doug was, and then the year before I was there with him, and then we were at Tennessee Tech together.
So have familiarity with you and George, yeah. The offensive coordinator. How much did that pay back?
Well, you know, that's huge. You know, not so much as me, but so much just in the offense, because while they're installing the offense, I don't think that, you know, George doesn't have to teach new schemes or new anything. They've already, you know, they had the number one scoring offense last year, so they know the things that they want to do. They know how they want to term them and do all those things. So I thought the carryover would be good as far as the continuity between George and himself. And I just know that he's a very good coach. He was a very good offensive coordinator when I was around him, and he's always had a good offensive background.
So where are you with the coaching staff? You let guys go at the end of the season. Is this where you thought you'd be with the coaching staff in early February?
Yeah. You know, and there's one more position, a defensive special teams assistant position that we're going to add at the beginning of March. So there's one more position, and that's why, you know, it's not finalized yet. We have one more guy that we're going to add.
What about a running backs coach?
You know what? I've been on several teams that, you know, and of course, she's so good, I didn't think he needed a coach, put it that way. I think he's just that awesome. But, no, I think George and those guys, you know, they'll coach by committee. There are some days when he'll coach the running backs, and I'm sure Tuck will, and also Kahari.
Defensive special teams? That's something new, is it not?
For me, no. But it's just we'll add one more position, and he'll probably work with the defense and special teams. It'll be in an assistant role.
Will this special teams assistant maybe be a little more experienced in the special teams field? Not as experienced in that?
Whoever it is, they'll be special teams. They'll have some special teams experience. You know, we wanted to add that. And then also they'll be able to help us out on defense.
Why do you have that role?
Because I wanted it.
Because you have a coordinator, you have two defensive backs coaches, you have a linebackers coach, a linebacker coach.
Probably because I'm just a defensive head coach, and I just want to make sure defense is good. No, it's just one of those, you know, even before last year, we talked about adding a special teams assistant. You know, whether Craig was here or not, we were going to add a special teams assistant. So it was something that we already had in the budget, so it just fits in.
For Bob, is there maybe already a good special teams foundation in place with what's been left?
Oh, definitely, definitely. You know, it's the same thing with George. We have some foundation. We've laid a good foundation here. We'll build upon it. And the same thing, there's some things that we won't change as far as the special teams. Like I said, he knows it. He's been around it. He helped coach it last year. It's just simply him being elevated into the role of the special teams coordinator and making sure that, you know, everything's where it needs to be.
How much of a difference do you think it will be with the change in the offensive line from a guy that's, you know, pretty intense? And I mean, how do you think the offensive line will basically respond to probably a pretty big personality change as well?
You know, he called Heenan on his birthday. Doug did, so I thought that was a plus. You know, the one thing about Doug is I've been around him several times, and the players love him because he's able to grab their attention. You know, they see him as somebody that wants to help them learn and get better. He will yell and scream when he needs to, but Doug is the kind of guy that, you know, he's laid back, but he gets them going. Like I said, I've been around Doug, and he's had good offenses wherever he's been, and I think they just respect him for his knowledge.